Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Pleasure to be here. For a while there, Vineet, with your analogies on vegetables, I thought you got into the grocery retailing business, but I guess not. I guess your existing business is pretty good, but maybe that's what you try and feed your customers. But we've been doing this for a while to each other all day, so this is just continuation of the same dialogue. As competitors, we certainly enjoy challenging each other as often as we can, so forgive me for that. The topic is changing rules for our industry, for the world, 2008, what will it look like? And I thought I'd make a few points. Obviously, many speakers before me have already made have pointed to some of the bigger issues here, but one is everybody talks about changing rules because it's a good thing to talk about, right? Because the world is going through change, cataclysmic change, companies will rise, companies will fall. Yes, all of that will happen. But let's also remember that we have barely scratched the tip of the surface of the industries in which we operate, particularly for those companies operating out of India or with a large base in India. The penetration levels in our industry are astonishingly low. The amount of business out there is humongous compared to the total amount of business that is done out of India, which may be, I don't know, some total of $10 billion versus the market of $300 billion. So there's room, one, for all of us, and I don't think there's any point in too many of us getting into a lather just worrying about what may happen. I'm not saying don't worry about it, I'm just saying there's no panic here at all. Given that, I'd just like to make a few points, and I certainly would love to join hands with Vineet in looking at Mr. Ham's slides here and, you know, helping improve them. firstly, I think what's going to happen? I think there's going to be a flight to quality, clearly. I think we all know that. And there's going to be an increasing flight to quality and to companies which have critical mass, have domain expertise, have knowledge bases, have scale, can deliver globally. No question about it. You have to be able to deliver globally, you have to have a presence globally. But I think most companies of size and scale are already doing that. They are there globally, or they're making the investments today. Two, I do disagree with the slide on incumbents versus newcomers, etc. Because when I talk to a customer, I haven't met a customer yet who has been transformed by these incumbents, you know. They all say they've been there in transformation business. I ain't met anyone yet. I don't know why. I don't know who they're serving, but I'd love to see them and I'd love to talk to them. I also think a failure rate of something like 40% on big projects, which I think Dennis and others might agree with, is imagine a failure rate of 40% in any other product in the world. But in our industry, for some reason, it is considered acceptable and has been considered acceptable by all these incumbents. It's an astonishing number, and I just always cease to be amazed by the fact that the world seems to accept that as par for the course. Why should it be? And I think the gap between local companies and incumbents is narrowing rapidly and will continue to do so. I'd love to meet companies. Yes, do they have great research capability? Absolutely. Yes, do they have great relationship capabilities? Absolutely. Yes, do they have some of the smartest people in our industry working with them? Absolutely. But on the opposite side, you've got a lot of other things going for companies which are perhaps based here or have large presence here. Flexibility, nimbleness, and don't discount hunger. Don't discount hunger. Don't discount pioneering. Dell broke through when it did break through because of the hunger of some people. That's how you change business models. That's how you change paradigms. It's not just about strategy. It's not about pluses and minuses. It's about hunger, about, as I think you rightly said, Steve, not paying lip service to things which are truly require commitment. You know, quality, customer service, customer satisfaction, responsiveness to customers. I mean, I think our industry has overpromised and underdelivered, as far as I can tell. I'm relatively new to it, for a very long time. And that has to change. And I hope we, as a forum here and as part of the industry, can help make that change. I think the biggest danger for many of us is as we grow larger and in scale, will we inherit the same disadvantages of many large companies who may be our competitors, or sometimes the disadvantages that we see in some of our customers? Too much formality, too many silos, inadequate exchange of best practices, inadequate exchange of information, different poles working, different regions working out of step with each other. All of those things are things we are in danger of inheriting, because as we become bigger, we have to put on greater controls, manage risks more tightly, and all of that can lead to being slower, being less responsive, and perhaps not retaining the nimbleness and fleetness of foot that one should. So managing our growth is, I think, the key challenge for most of us. I also think we have a huge danger, and I think you would probably accuse me of saying this, of having done this right now, of pronouncing victory too early. Victory will or will not come in 10 years' time. Victory is not going to come now, it's not going to come in the next year, it's not going to come in the year after. I suspect in some fashion we will be having a similar debate, perhaps slightly different topics, 2 years from now. But our industry is new. It's growing enormously around the world. It's one of the fastest growth industries in the world. And there's room for all of us. But in the meantime, let's also not get scared or be panicked. Those who are considered the best in the world may not be the best. And some of us who are much smaller may be fleet enough to catch them. Thank you.